Tourists are back. Sumptuous foods are all over the major streets in the metro. Dinagyang fever is on. Dinagyang is held every fourth Sunday of January or right after the Ati-Atihan Inaklan and Sinulog Festival in Cebu. Dinagyang Festival is celebrated in order to give tribute to the Christianization of the natives and to give honor to Señor Santo Niño. And the arrival on Panay of Malay settlers and the subsequent selling of the island to them by the Atis. One important event in celebrating Dinagyang is the installation of the Hermano and Hermana Mayor every year. This year, our very own City Vice Mayor, Joe III Espinosa, and his wife, Mrs. Gina Agnes Sarabia Espinosa, was chosen to be the successor of Don Rogelio Florete and Doña Imelda Florete. The Hermano and Hermana Mayor takes care of the various religious activities that will be undertaken by the San Jose Parish for the entire year. They are expected to be present in every activity of the parish.
Thank you. safety corners in Pag-ulikid. We beseech you to cast a merciful eye on our troubled hearts. Let your loving love so inclined to thee be softened at our prayers and grant us that grace for which we ardently implore you. Take from us all unbearable affliction and despair. For your sacred infancy's sake, hear our prayers and send us consolation and aid that we may praise you with the Father and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Karon lang tahong naton ang gosos o kung ang pato palami sa forma. With feelings and full of love kay Señor Santo Niño.
Thanks be to God!
Happy Fiesta!
Thanks be to God!
Thank you, God!
People were bringing children to Jesus that he might touch them. But the disciples rebuked him. When Jesus saw this, he became indignant and said to them, "Let the children come to me. Do not prevent them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as this. Amen, I say to you, whoever does not accept the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it." Then he embraced the children and blessed them, placing his hands on them. The Gospel of the Lord.
The theme of our Eucharistic celebration this year, on the occasion of the Feast of Senor Santo Niño, is Santo Niño, Hope of the Poor. Santo Niño, Hope of the Poor. And this is very much in line with the declaration of the Catholic Bishops Conference of the Philippines, declaring the year 2015 as the Year of the Poor. Katatapos ng year 2014, which was the year of the late. So 2015 is the year of the poor. Of course, when we talk about the poor, we are referring not so much to those who are materially poor. Yung mga walang pera, yung mga walang trabaho, yung walang bahay, we don't refer so much to them. When we talk about the poor, we are referring to those who are poor in spirit, those who are poor in heart. And these people, the poor, have been declared by our Lord Jesus Christ as blessed. Sa kanyang famous Sermon on the Mount, or the Beatitudes, he said, "Blessed are the poor, for theirs is the kingdom of God." Of course, spiritual poverty can take on many different concrete expressions or concrete manifestations, which we usually see in kids, in children, in young people. Again, this is very much in line with our representation of our Lord Jesus Christ as a Santo Niño, as a child. Now, when you think about children, of course, there are things that come spontaneously to your mind. How would you describe children? Ano ba yung mga essential characteristics of a child or of children? Let me name some of them. First, when we think about children, one of the first things that come to our mind is their being simple. So the virtue of simplicity. Simplicity in their way of thinking. Simplicity also as far as desires or the things that they want are concerned. Simplicity also in the way they be. Kaya yung mga bata, dito may mga bata ako dito, no? You all know na hindi man mahirap pasayahin ang bata. Simple lang ang gusto ng mga bata, hindi pa complicated yung mga demands ng mga bata. Ang mga bata, bigyan mo lang nila candy, masaya na yan. Diba, no? Dali mo lang sa amusement park, masaya na yan. Bigyan mo lang kahit na nung simple regalo, masaya na ang bata. That's how simple they are. Unlike adults, unlike grown-ups, tayo ang mahirap isatisfy. Tayo ang mahirap i-please. So that's one thing that comes to our mind when we think about children, no? Simplicity. Second, spontaneity. Ang mga bata, very spontaneous. And it is this spontaneity that enables them to get along well, very easily with the people around them, especially with kids. Even kids who are totally unknown to them. Napasin ba ninyo, kapag sinasama ninyo yung mga anak-anak ninyo, no? Sa isang lugar, tapos yung mga bata, ang bilis makikipag-ilong mga bata. They get along so well very easily. Maya-maya lang, naglalaro rin. Maski kung nananalata na rin ang mga bata rin, no? That's how spontaneous children are. Unlike, again, grown-ups. Hindi na tayo doon ako spontaneous eh. Because grown-ups, no? Para tayong tumutong-tong sa numero, we're so keen about certain social norms, modes of behavior, no? Ingat na ingat tayo, ayaw natin magkali. Nawawala yung spontaneity natin. Third, transparency or honesty. Children are very honest. What you see is what you get. They will tell you exactly the things that pass through their heads. Hindi sila peke, no? Kung iniisip nila, sasabihin nila yan. Kung inarapan nila, ipapaalam na sa inyo yan. Kapag masama ang pakiramdam ng bata, sasabihin niya sa magulang niya. Kapag uncomfortable siya, sasabihin niya sa magulang niya. Kapag galit siya, ipapakita niya. No? Yan ang tinatawag natin yung transparency or honesty, which again, unfortunately, nawawala sa ating mga grown-ups. No? And then fourth, sabihin natin yung humility or sense of humility. Humility means you are aware of your limitations. You are aware of your imperfections. Ang mga bata, again, humble sila eh. Bakit? Alam kasi nila yung mga limitations nila. Physical limitation, intellectual limitation, emotional limitation. Alam na mga bata yan eh. Physical limitation, for example, children know that they can fend for themselves. Hindi na kaya ipagtanggol ng mga sarili nila. And because of that sense of humility, ang ganda yung virtue of trust. Ang mga bata, dependent sa mga adults, sa mga grown-ups, sa mga magulang nila, no? Kaya di ba ang mga bata, kapag limbawa meron silang kaaway o nakatakot sila, kanino sila tumatakbo? Sa mga grown-ups. Lumalapit sila sa atin because they know that on their own, they cannot defend themselves. They need the help of us, na mga medyo matatanda na, no? So that's humility that goes also with the virtue of trust, learning how to trust. Also the sense of dependence. Dependent ang mga bata sa atin. Dependent sila, for example, because we have to provide them with what they need, no? Food, drinks, clothing, education, and so forth. They are dependent sila sa mga grown-ups. Now, these are just some of the virtues and concrete expressions of what we call spiritual poverty, which we see, we observe normally in children. Ulitin natin, no? Simplicity, spontaneity, transparency, honesty, humility, yung pagiging trusting nila, yung kanilang sense of dependence, and so forth. And these are precisely the traits of children that please our Lord Jesus Christ. That's why in our gospel reading this morning, when people were trying to prevent children from coming to Him, Jesus Christ rebuked them. Sabi ni Jesus Christ, "Huwag niyong harangan ang mga bata. Let the children come to Me and forbid them not." Because Jesus liked children. You must have seen, you must have followed the activities of the Pope, no? During his recent visit to Pope Francis. Napansin ba ninyo how close Pope Francis was to kids? Kapag may nagulito siyang mga bata, pinapahinto niya yung paper mobile niya. Pinapahinto niya. Pinapalapan niya yung bata, no? To kiss the kid, to embrace the kid, no? And I think all of us will do the same thing because there is something that really attracts us to young people. Attracted tayo sa kanila. Natutuwa, hindi naman natutuwa tayo sa kanila. We are really attracted to them, attracted by their characteristics, by their virtues, by their simplicity and so forth, no? So Jesus Christ said, "Let the children come to Me and forbid them not." And also, these characteristics would enable us to establish an intimate relationship with God. Itong intimacy na to, again, we have seen this in our gospel reading. Intimacy or close relationship that Jesus had for His children manifested through concrete gestures. Napansin ba niyo sa gospel reading? Ano ginawa ni Jesus Christ, no? He touched the children. He embraced them. He put His hands on them to bless them, no? yung mga pompous gestures of intimacy. Tayo mga Pilipino, we are known worldwide for being cariñoso. Cariñoso tayo. We are very affectionate. And one of the ways in which we express that our being cariñoso is through pompous gestures. Kaya kapamahal natin yung mga tao, of course you have to demonstrate that. And you demonstrate that exactly in the way that Jesus demonstrated his intimate relationship with children. Kaya tayo pamahal natin yung mga bata. We embrace them, we kiss them, di ba? Inahawakan natin yan, alagahan natin yan, and so forth, no? So, by having the same traits, the same characteristics of children, practically, we can have an intimate relationship with God, as we have seen in our gospel reading. Now, my dear brothers and sisters, unfortunately, as we grow up, and as we go through different experiences, lalo na mga painful experiences, we tend to lose these childlike traits. Take note that I said childlike, hindi childish. The Lord is not teaching us to be childish. The Lord is teaching us to be childlike. Kaya sabi niya, no? Unless you become like a child, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Yung pagiging childlike natin is one requisite taught to us by the Lord Jesus Christ. If you want to enter the kingdom of God, if you want to. But as I said, unfortunately, as we grow up, we tend to lose these childlike characteristics or traits. But, of course, we should not despair. Bakit? May pag-asa pa naman eh. It doesn't follow the same thing because matanda na tayo that we cannot recover or possess those childlike characteristics anymore. We can. Otherwise, our Lord Jesus Christ should not have indicated them as the requisites to enter the kingdom of God. That's why we're talking more about childlike characteristics or being poor, spiritually speaking. You know, it is a being, you know. We can do this, for example, if we just follow the teachings and the examples of our Lord Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ, when he talked about spiritual poverty or being like a child, he did that not only through words, but through concrete actions. Napakinggan natin sa level of Philippians, no? Jesus Christ was God, and yet he learned how to humble himself, becoming like one of us. Yan ang concrete gesture of humility to Jesus Christ. O naalala niyo what Jesus Christ did during the Last Supper, no? Although he was the master, he humbled himself by serving those who were under him, by washing the feet of his disciples. And yung mga concrete expressions, gestures na ni Jesus Christ, no? To help us understand the real meaning of his teachings. So kailangan, those two things should go together. Preaching or teaching with words and teaching through concrete examples. Okay? Now, my dear brothers and sisters, today as we celebrate the feast of Senor Santo Niño, now Jesus Christ himself, who took on the form of a child, let us pray to him so that we can remain faithful to his teachings and in this way recover those childlike characteristics which we need if we really want to become a part of his kingdom, if we want to establish an intimate relationship with him, if we want to please God, and if we want to be saved. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now stand to profess our faith.